The government of the United States has long been under the radar for allegedly hiding something unknown related to the UFOs and aliens. Now, the 1947 UFO crash, which took place in New Mexico and left the world shocked, has again resurfaced after recently leaked government texts revealed that there was more to it than what was known to the people. The partially redacted communication was posted on social media, and a top-ranking intelligence official was noted as saying that people would be slack-jawed to know the complete truth. The story of the 1953 crash has been retold 15 times by the locals of the area. On May 21, multiple people reportedly witnessed one UFO crash outside a small Mojave desert city, which is nearly 100 miles from Las Vegas. It's very rare to have multiple witnesses, multiple sources of information confirming an incident like this, said Preston Dennett, who is the author of The UFOs Over Arizona, a true history of extraterrestrial encounters in the Grand Canyon state, while speaking to local Channel 12 News. In another interview with AZ Central, Dennett said that the occurrence was one of the best verified UFO crashes in the United States. After many years, Dennett has found traces of the incident in the government's old reports and documents. He found that scientist Fritz Warner was frequently mentioned using a code name. "We now know him to be Arthur Stenzel," said Dennett. "It was Stenzel's job to basically determine the speed of this object as it came down, based upon the gouge it made it in the soil. And he estimated it was about 1200 miles per hour," he added. In a conversation between former Deputy Assistant Secretary of Defense Christopher Mellon and another official, the latter reportedly said that people would be slack-jawed when they found out what the government had found about the incident. The government is also aware who recovers crashed UAPs, unidentified anomalous phenomena, under what authorities, he said. "We are vacuuming up info. We also know that a still highly classified memo by our Secretary of the United States Air Force is still in fact to maintain the cover on UAPs." Read the partially redacted conversation.